At the macro level, we are seeing the numbers stabilizing. Many are asking, when are the people at the ordinary level in terms of the social impact of all these things we are seeing? When are we going to feel that impact? Because there are some who still think that we are not feeling the impact.
I mean, I think it's good to agree as a first point that we are beginning to see a turnaround in the numbers at the macro level. Admittedly, when you talk of trickle-down economics, it takes a while for it to trickle down. And we're expecting that sooner than later it will trickle down. But I think the president's also being clear that we need to quicken efforts that ensure trickling down. That's why, for example, if you take growth is about how is the economy expanding or gearing up productivity. The target was about 1.5. But I think the president was quite clear that some efforts need to be put in place, particularly in the area of agriculture, etc., to ensure that it picks up faster than the 1.5. And already we are seeing about a 3.3, 3.2. Coupled with that also then means that food price inflation will be tinkering down a little bit. And so the idea is to quicken it so that it trickles down faster.
And are we going to see anything change, or we are still going to be on the trajectory because those past policy measures have seen the macro numbers moving towards the direction that some may describe it as good?
I mean, I think you're going to see a deepening of the measures that are bringing about the turnaround. On the growth side, the president has asked for a jobs and growth plan to be submitted to him. I know the Ministry of Finance and the related ministries have done a lot of work on it. It should be signed off the coming weekend or so at the cabinet retreat. And then you see a deepening of the growth agenda. On the cost of living side, which has been one of our biggest challenges as a country in the last about, 1.5 years or so, the central bank is continuing with its tightening policy. They've been quite clear about that. It's helping on the non-food side, and the rail sector side, led by Agric Ministry and Transport Ministry, are also working to ensure that on the food side they can also help to bring it down a little bit. So again, there as well, you see a deepening of the efforts. And then if you go to the fiscal side, we are clear that we want to keep the primary balance in shape, so that we're able to reduce the rate of new debt accumulation. I think if you look at the numbers for the first two quarters of the year, it tells you that again we're on track on that, and there will be a deepening of that as well. So long and short is that you will see a deepening of the efforts that are bringing about the turnaround in the second well, in the final quarter of the year.
Tell me more about this jobs and growth document that cabinet is set to give a green light to. Why this? Because some say that the policies are already there. It's
Yes.
about fast tracking and strict commitment, whipping all the agencies to line to implement.
Absolutely. But if that was to hold, then no government will even prepare an economic program or a budget. You need to always be examining the results from what you are doing and seeing what you can do more of, which is working, and stop doing what is not working. It's in that context that growth programmed at 1.5, the president said, I need this thing to move faster, because growth comes with jobs usually, and jobs bring incomes to people. Incomes allow people to have a higher quality of life. So the president says, I'm seeing 1.5, can we do better than 1.5? What do we do? You detail out the measures you need to take, and now you're beginning to see it. Next year, what is it, 2.8? If nothing happens, so what are you going to do to move it from 2.8 to maybe 3 or 3.5? Those are the additional measures that you need to take. So it's in that context that he's asking us to deepen all the measures that are being taken.